Hairs, phoenix tail feathers, and the hot streamers of dragons. And no two Olivander wands are the same, just as no two unicorns, dragons, or phoenixes are quite the same. The wand of hazel, 13 inches long, flexible, and swishy. Eli, let's try a spell. Oh, let's see if we can brighten this place a bit by illuminating the tip of your wand. Now, just hold it up in the air and say, Lumos.
Lumos.
Nicely done. Oh, you're very powerful, my friend. Meteorology. Great canto.
Oh, my God.
Most impressive. That is definitely not your wand. Don't worry. Your wand is here. We shall find it. Oh, let's try a longer wand, perhaps. There we are. A wand of oak, 16 and a half inches long, rather bendy. There you are. Now, yes. I'd like you to ring that bell.
Oh, yeah.
One time, one time only, please. When you're ready, well, let's try a non-verbal spell. When you're ready, give your wand a wave, my friend. Just one time. There we are. Oh, very impressive. You're getting closer, I think. You're doing very well, Eli. Now, my friends, it's always been very clear to those of us studying wand lore that the wand chooses the wizard. But it's not always so clear as to why. I wonder, there is a wand that's been here a long time.